Shalom Chavrim, I'm Stephen Ben-Nun. You're watching Israeli News Live. I am so glad that we're able to get back in the swing of things here, get news out to you. We are still battling, though, an internet issue here. Hopefully by either Monday or Tuesday, we will have our upload speed corrected there. As of right now, just a 15-20 minute broadcast takes about 3 hours to upload, really hindering us on our breaking news there, as well as we're wanting to go live on YouTube here in the very next coming week or so. Hope to have that up and running for you so we can really cover things that are happening. We do have an internet expert coming in to try to resolve that here in Orlando, where we're staying here for the next month or so. Also where we are going to be hosting a conference here in late October, mid-October there. As of right now, we are looking at the 14th and 15th. This is the same conference that we were speaking about possibly running in September. So just keep that in mind. Let's get right into the news. We'll talk about a little about these things here in just a few moments here. Two stories that we are following right now. Very serious situation in Charlottesville, Virginia. Charlottesville, Virginia there. We have clashes with KKK protesters there, white supremacists there, going through the streets, beating black people in some videos that we've seen. Very disturbing video footage to see such hatred amongst people against their own fellow citizens here of the United States there. It has also, there was a car crash that has left 19 people injured. Very serious situation there. And of course, police helicopter crashes, leaves both police officers dead, according to Sputnik News. But that's not the only news that is breaking. We're going to come back to this in just a moment here. But also, as what came out yesterday, Beijing has talked about they will back North Korea if the U.S. does a preemptive strike. You know, it's kind of interesting. We've been sharing this here with you on Israeli News Live for, what, a month or better already, that China, from the very beginning, almost 2 months ago, I suppose, we've been saying that China would back North Korea if the United States struck North Korea. We saw this move. We saw that President Trump, thinking that he had President Xi in his pocket there, thinking that he could use a little bit of leverage with the financial ties with America, that just did not work. Now, Beijing has been very careful in the way they've noted this. They have warned also Kim Jong-un that if Kim Jong-un were to strike, now notice this, U.S. mainland, then they will refrain from helping North Korea if the U.S. strikes back, retaliates. But they've also, and this was not directly from the Chinese government, but from media that is very much controlled by Beijing's government there, the communist government there, they have come out and said that China will indeed protect North Korea if the United States does a preemptive strike. We're seeing this in two different articles, this here being on Newsweek. China would join forces with North Korea if U.S. launches preemptive strike. Also, the WashingtonPost.com, China won't come to North Korea's aid if it launches missiles threatening U.S. soil, and there is retaliation, a state-owned newspaper warned Friday, but it would intervene if Washington strikes first. The Global Times newspaper is not an official mouthpiece of the Communist Party, but in this case, its editorial probably does reflect government policies, experts have said. Very, very troubling situation here, and as I had stated before, Israeli News Live, we have been saying this to you for, what, 2 months, I guess, already. And now mainstream media is just now catching up, picking up this story, and finally coming out and revealing this. As we brought out, China does have an agreement signed with North Korea to protect it if it's ever attacked. This was going all the way back to the 60s after the Korean War. China signed that. Very strong political ties there. And of course, we cannot help but remember Daniel's prophecy at chapter 11, verse 44, but tidings out of the east and out of the north shall affrighten him. Affrighten or cause great anxiety is the Hebrew word right here. And who is it cause anxiety for? The king of the north. That is a king that is running NATO military forces, including the United States, Great Britain, and other NATO allies. And now President Trump working with Macron, the French president, about trying to defuse the situation with North Korea. It is a very serious situation, very tense situation going on there, and very biblical, no doubt. And of course, tidings out of the east being China. Note it, it is first in the biblical prophecy. China was the first to move the Dongfeng 41 intercontinental ballistic missiles. It carries 10 nuclear warheads on the tip of these missiles here. They moved them to the northeastern province of China long before it really started getting really bad over there. Then Russia moved the bulk of them to their southeastern border there along North Korea there. It would take out Tomahawk cruise missiles. Russia moved in a dozen ships, submarines there off the coast of Russia near Vladivostok. They're close to North Korea as well. Troubling, friends. It is a troubling situation, as the biblical prophecy says, tidings out of the east, now the north, will frighten him. Going back to the situation in North Carolina, all kinds of news coming out about this, and of course want to share some of this with you here. This here is one angle of this car coming in, just ramming these people on world on alert. We have other footages as well, showing just very serious violence here inside of the city of Charlottesville, Virginia. If I say North Carolina, forgive me there, my brain is kind of stuck on that for some reason. But also the protesters, it's been very, very violent there in the city there. As you can see here, we have fighting going on here between both white supremacists and those that have come out in favor for, you know, equality. And really, that's the way it should be. We have no need for supremacy of one race over another. That is clear Nazism from the very beginning, and Nazism is deplorable from the very outset of everything there. So a very troubling situation. As you can see, also the white supremacists are all, in many cases, are very well protected. They're well armed. They have their own mace guns. They have their own riot gear, so to speak. It's just really kind of odd how this situation is kind of unfolded there. Kind of backing up here on Fox News' report here, showing clashes there between the two groups. And you would almost think it's police officers trying to push back protesters, but it's not. It's white supremacists. They got their boxing gloves on, got a vest on, bulletproof vest on as well. I mean, this is a troubling situation, friends. Very troubling situation that's going there in Charlottesville, Virginia. We've seen former President Bill Clinton, First Lady also of Washington, President Trump's wife, coming out, speaking out against this. The violence is happening there. This here is images from the helicopter, the police helicopter that actually crashed here on your screen now. Another helicopter overhead, the smoke rising up. That was the actual helicopter there that had crashed. Very, very troubling situation there in Charlottesville, Virginia. Not to mention all the problems going on with North Korea. Will the United States actually strike first? Will the United States try to make it look like Pyongyang launches the first attack in order to justify retaliation, hoping China doesn't weigh in on this fight? Time will only tell. All I can tell you is clearly a biblical sign. We're going to kind of limit our time here on our news broadcast because of our internet issues here. We hope to have those resolved here in the next few days there. We are running into internet upload time. We're only having 2 megabytes per second that can upload, which is very difficult for high definition. We may downgrade these just to normal quality there for a few days here until we can get that resolved to get the breaking news up to you faster. And also, just letting you know, we are still trying to rapidly put together this emergency prophetic geopolitical summit there. We have right now Dr. Steve Pidgeon, Paul Begley, myself, my wife as well, dealing with transhumanism, all these different subjects of the situation that is happening in the world today coming together. We're going to reach out to L.A. Marzulli as well. Hopefully he can come, and we will be doing this in Orlando. Tentatively, we are now looking at October the 14th and 15th, and we should have the details finalized by Wednesday this coming week. We hope to have that all finalized so that you can make plans if you want to be here. Definitely send us an email. Let us know if you'd like to be here at stephenbenoon@gmail.com. Love to hear from you about that. And also as well, don't forget, we do need your help in keeping this type broadcast on the air. I'm Stephen Benoon with Israeli News Live. Shalom.